Believe it or not, this isn't the set of a John Wayne movie. This is Caprock Canyon State Park. And who better to show us around the 15,000 acres than Park Superintendent Donald Beard?
Historically, this was a ranching property.
Now, Caprock Canyon State Park is home to bison, prairie dogs, and so much more. Now, that includes over 300 archaeological sites. But now, keep in mind, only half of the park has been surveyed so far. But remember, anything you see, do not touch.
It's very important to realize that all animals, plants, rocks, everything in the state park are protected. So if you do run across something, you know, you need to leave it alone, take a couple pictures of it, show it to the park staff.
The most popular of the sites, the Lake Theo Folsom Bison Kill Site, excavated in 1972.
When the archaeologists did the excavation, they found tools dating back to Folsom Man, which is over 10,000 years old. That means man has been hunting bison in this park, in this country, for over 10,000 years.
And over the past decade alone, the park's visitation has more than doubled, from 36,000 to 100,000 visitors annually. Beard contributing recent growth to the pandemic, but a consistent factor has always been the bison.
It's just amazing to think of the history of how many people have been here before us, and these footsteps that we're leaving now, what are we walking over? What has been here before us?
Alex Setti, Destination Texas.
Gearing up in an effort to take on Mount Kilimanjaro. This is how Brandon Madison has been spending the last few months.
You know, we're in the plains, you know, Panhandle of Texas. There's not a lot of altitude here. So I've been doing a lot of walking, a lot of miles on my boots, weight on my back.
Luckily, he's not alone today. His daughter Sakara is here for support. Plus, she gets to spend some extra time with her hero.
He is funny. He gets me whatever I want. and he hugs me when I'm scared.
Madison knows about looking out for others. This hometown hero has received multiple awards, medals, and letters of commendation.
I've been there for other guys that had the same backstory as me because I had already been through it. And I was able to walk next to them and facilitate some sort of fellowship and healing with them because of the horrible things that I've been through.
Madison has faced an uphill climb personally. He was diagnosed with a brain tumor at 28. And has had his share of struggles with PTSD. Training for this climb was derailed more than a month ago because of surgery, but that is not keeping him from this opportunity.
To climb Kilimanjaro, I've heard people talk about it before, and it's quite an accomplishment. So to just to be asked and to have it facilitated by a nonprofit and by the people at Sheepdog is just amazing that they're doing that for us.
Sheepdog Impact Assistance put the trip together, taking four Purple Heart recipients to the top of Kilimanjaro, along with six other veterans, including Madison.
Big why is to inspire others, to inspire men and women from every background to appreciate that you have to quit with the excuses on why you can't and why you don't. Do your best to live your best life.
Sergeant Major Lance Nutt founded the organization 11 years ago to help first responders and members of the military.
And as we thought about it, the realization was that in helping others through our difficult times, we quickly realized that we were better for it.
Madison will tell you he's better for it.
Pain shared is pain divided, and You're not a lesser. You're not weak for doing it. You're not weak to be emotional about it. That's all human traits, and it's all about healing.
Healing while helping others, doing it one step at a time.
Thank you. time.